Good evening. Welcome back. Start you off again with the radar. All the satellites and radar are running. The storm system that's causing this is gone. It is already up by the Great Lakes. But because of pockets of trapped moisture, what we call northwest flow bouncing off of the mountains up there, it's actually creating little pockets of lift that are turning it into snow. Simply put, if you're planning to go through the pass tonight, I would rethink that. Winter weather, National Weather Service has a winter weather advisory in effect over Vail, Aspen, and 70 east of Glenwood Springs all the way into Denver until later tonight. I'm just about these images to give you an idea. You're fine up in the Grand Mesa. If you really wanted to get up there for some reason, there's about 5 inches of snow. You're fine between here and Glenwood Springs. You're even fine in the Red Mountain Pass. Where you're not fine is the Vail Pass. That's about 12 minutes ago, that image there. That is almost whiteout conditions. And while they haven't shut it down, because, hey, we're from Colorado and we know how to drive, that's still pretty close to borderline of maybe being shut down. So don't even try it. Just wait 24 hours, let it melt off, go through then. 54, winds west at 6, humidity 24, dew point 18, pressure rising down here in the valleys at 30.15. Temps in the high country just above freezing, but thanks to what's known as wet bowl, which I'll explain later tonight at 10 o'clock, you can still get snow at 34 and 36. For the rest of us, upper 40s to low 50s, upper 50s on the Utah side. Good 5 to 7 degrees cooler in every location due to a decent amount of sunshine. Even where we're having snow now, it was actually sunny earlier today. Winds out of the northwest at 5 to 15 with a few gusts up to 20. Problem is, there's not a lot of moisture to work with. The only reason we're getting it up there is little pockets of moisture trapped between the valleys. Generally, dew points are anywhere from the teens to low 20s. And here's the key, humidity. The snow that they already had over the weekend melted off in the sunshine, at least portions of it this morning. That went back into its gas form. 61 Aspen, 40 in Glenwood Springs, 50 in Gunnison, the zone that has the pockets of snow. For us, 30 in Montrose, 24 in Grand Junction, 19 in Moab. Bone dry environment for the valleys. When we go to the wide and state imaging, you can see those little pockets of snow that are developing, but you notice there's nothing out to the east. That's because the storm is long gone. When we take a look at temps, we're in the 30s in the high country. They're getting a wet bulb effect snow for us, 54, 47 in Denver, 47 in Colorado Springs. Yeah, do you see the same thing? Zone where we're seeing the snow melt off has brought humidities up. Now, when we look at the smoke forecast, let me talk about a couple issues. I put a locator on that fire as we run through the statewide snow projector because there will be a couple more chances here. But if you notice, best of the stuff goes into Colorado Springs, down by Trinidad, and, of course, over Steamboat Springs and Vail, putting just enough there to slow the fire, but not enough that's going to put that thing out. So that fire will continue until they can get control of it. Storm's core from the weekend has already pulled away up to the Great Lakes. It actually created a tornado last night in Dallas, taking lives, doing damage. Came right during the Cowboys game, and it did a lot downtown, right off the edge of the Metroplex. But for us, next storm system is on its way. Computer, a little ahead of itself. We don't expect it to actually reach us till Wednesday night into Thursday. So what I'm going to show you now on the model run, go ahead and back that up by about 12 hours. The computer is just moving that cold front too fast. Clear skies tonight. Little pockets are trapped up there, so that winds up creating a couple little spots of snow. This will be Wednesday afternoon into Thursday, not Tuesday into Wednesday, because, again, the cold front will slow down, and that energy is connected to it. Other than that, we've got a fairly mild pattern. Snow projector off the next system, calling for just a couple of inches in the high country over the resorts and maybe 6 inches up off the pass itself. For tonight, we are looking at mostly clear skies down here. Elevation does make a difference. Overnight low of 30, mostly clear and cold, light winds below freezing. So bring the pets in. By now, you know whether or not your pipes are going to be able to take it because we've had several nights where it goes down below freezing. Across the region, we will see overnight lows close to single digits in the high country. 11 Gunnison, 22 in Aspen, 29 in Glade Park. Montrose looking at about 27 as well. How does that factor over the next 7 days? Well, as we put it into motion for you, if I can get it up, there you go. 61, 64, 55, 58, 64, 66, back to 52. The next two storm systems are Wednesday night to Thursday and Sunday night into Monday. We're going to keep an eye on it. We'll track them down with tomorrow night's forecast coming up at the end of the broadcast.